Hello, my beautiful people. I am back here in my bedroom. I haven't shot with this background in a long time. And that is because I am officially moved back into my dad's house. I'm gonna be here for a while. I'm planning on this summer really focusing on YouTube and this channel. I'm really looking forward to this summer. I think that it's gonna be really fun and there's gonna be a lot of cool stuff to come. Also, I got home probably like 2 weeks ago and have been taking a break just because if you saw my dealing with stressful times more gracefully video, you know that I was under a lot of stress and that stress really caught up to me. I ended up not making videos for a few weeks. But I'm back and well rested. I have just been kind of having fun and being creative the last couple weeks. I made this bracelet here, which you can even check out my wire wrapping skills. So yeah, I've just been having fun making bracelets, coloring, working out, really just recalibrating myself and getting rested. Because I was so tired. I was so tired and so drained, but now I'm done and I'm super happy because 18 years of schooling is a lot of schooling. And I don't really want to go back right now. Maybe grad school in the future, but not for a while. But anyway, so if you're new here, by the way, hello, I'm Nicole and this is Nurturing Compassion. Here on this channel, I talk about compassionate living, sustainable living, veganism, and animal rights, some self-love in there too. And it's all just good vibes, so welcome. And if this is stuff you're interested in, consider hitting the red subscribe button. To talk about vegans and how we can turn our anger into compassion, because when you are a vegan, it is very easy to get angry and upset with the world, with the state of our planet, with the way that we treat animals, and it's easy to just get really, really angry and upset. But that's really no way to live. We want to be spreading love and compassion to the world, and we do that not by feeding into that anger. We need to treat others with love and respect, even if they aren't doing the same to our animal brothers and sisters. And this was something that was really hard for me to wrap my head around when I first went vegan. Even just as a vegetarian, I didn't understand at all how people can eat meat, how they could just have such cognitive dissonance, and it especially was upsetting when people would say they were animal lovers, but yet they would consume meat. And now as a vegan, I feel like at first those emotions kind of strengthened. I was just so upset and angry, but at the same time, I've learned that not only does that not help the animals, but it doesn't help me either. And I think that a really good example is actually with all of this ex-vegan drama on YouTube. For a while, I was so upset. I mean, especially some of the YouTubers were ones that I watched pretty frequently, really helped me with my vegan transition. And when they came out as no longer vegan, it felt so shocking, it felt so betraying, and I would read a lot of the comments in these people's videos. I watched a whole lot of response videos, and I found myself getting so sad. Like, I found myself getting sad, I found myself feeling negative, and it was just amazing how a few hours of this literally bogged down my mood for a couple weeks. Like, I literally felt my vibration lowering. It was shortly after that that I decided that I needed to cut myself off. So for like a whole month, I refused to watch any kind of ex-vegan response video. I refused to read the comments or watch the videos of these influencers that they put up since their I'm No Longer Vegan videos. And I found that I did get better. But it was just incredible because it wasn't even me making any of these comments or making these response videos. I mean, I did make a why I will always be vegan video. So I guess I did kind of do a response video in a way, but I was just amazed by how it negatively just watching and observing this content made me feel. And so I think that part of that is what's inspiring this video. Basically, what it comes down to is think about the animals and then think about yourself. By putting out negativity and anger towards others, you're not really affecting them all that much. What you're really doing is hurting yourself, and you're hurting the animal rights movement. Something that I've really used to overcome this, because of course we're so passionate about animal rights and we're so upset by all of the horrors that animals experience. But what can we do with that anger to use it the most efficiently? And so number one would be, when you get angry, stop yourself. Stop yourself and say, anger, I see you. Why are you making me feel this way? Why am I so angry? And just by doing that act, you almost get yourself out of the loop of just feeling pure anger, because you're able to recognize that you yourself are not that emotion. You're not anger, but you're a human being who's feeling anger, and possibly you are consciousness that is witnessing a human being experiencing anger. And simply by doing that, by questioning it, by acknowledging it, you are able to deal with it better, because you're not stuck in this mindset that this is who you are, this is what is happening right now, and there's nothing you can do to change it. And so then you just ask questions like, why am I feeling this way? And what is it specifically about this situation or what this person said that is making me feel anger, when this stuff is happening all the time and I'm not constantly feeling angry? Perhaps it just shows that there's more that you need to do in terms of your vegan journey. You know, it's really broad, so just making sure that you are living the best example that you can of veganism, that you are making sure you're getting all your vitamins and nutrients, that you are exercising and spoiling yourself, that you're happy. And I'm not saying that you have to be this perfect idealistic version of yourself in order to be a vegan, or you're a bad vegan if you don't do that, but ultimately you will influence people more if you're radiating health and positivity, and you do that not just through your vegan diet, though that is a very big part of it, but also through taking care of yourself and actually just being a positive, happy person. I think that when people see vegans happy and literally glowing, that says more than words ever could. People are inspired by that. People want to emulate that. So really, just focusing on your own happiness rather than this anger and this emotion that's come up inside you will do wonders. Further, when you are able to separate from this anger, you're more likely to respond in a kinder, more compassionate way, which is what we want, because that's what veganism is about. It's about love and compassion for all beings. You never know what you say in that conversation that could potentially be what sets that person off for thinking about veganism, and you are more likely to reach that person through kindness and understanding. Even if that's not what they're giving to you, I think that it does stick out to people when you give them kindness, even when they make it difficult to do that. So a second way that you can turn your anger into compassion, especially towards someone who isn't vegan or has said something negative about you being vegan, is to remember a time when you weren't vegan. So many of us have had a time like this, unless you were raised by vegan parents and have been vegan your whole life, which is awesome. Good for you. I guess you can skip to number three. But many of us remember a time when we ate meat or we ate animal products, and possibly we may have even been those people that were like, where do you get your protein? Is veganism even healthy? Bacon though. Oh my god. That is the worst argument. But I think that by putting ourselves in these people's shoes and remembering that there was a time where we were just like that can be very helpful. Even if, I mean, I know me personally, I've always wanted to be a vegetarian since I realized that meat was meat, but I know that there's surely I enjoyed eating meat and that I thought that I couldn't be vegetarian because my dad said no. And so just remembering that people are going through different things, people are internalizing the world in different ways, and that there was a time where maybe your beliefs did not align with your actions. When you're able to remember this time, you're really able to sympathize more with that person. And I'm a big advocate of treating yourself with love and forgiveness, but we should also do that towards other people because other people are also learning and growing. And again, you never know how what you say can impact a person to become a vegan or a vegetarian. So just really try to sympathize with them by remembering that you were not always vegan yourself. The third way that you can turn your anger into compassion is actually just by taking your anger and using it for activism, baby. And what I mean by that is, especially with these ex-vegans, the internet is just permeating with all of these angry vegan comments. And that's a really bad look for all of us. I mean, I understand, like, animals are the most important in this movement, in this diet, and if you really cared about animals, you wouldn't eat them. But at the same time, we are making the whole vegan community look like a bunch of just rude, mean people, and a lot of people don't see it our way, and I don't think that we are swaying people with the negativity. The fact of the matter is, you're not changing this YouTuber's mind. They're either sick or they're in a la-la land mind space where all they really cared about the whole time was being skinny and they don't actually care about the animals, so it doesn't matter what you say. So why would you waste your time and your energy towards this person when you can channel more of that energy towards activism? I mean, you might not be able to reach this person on YouTube, but you know what? You never know how passing out a leaflet to some guy walking down the street will impact him. Going and leafleting and protesting and engaging in veg fest, or even just cooking a vegan meal for your friend and not telling him till afterwards that it was vegan. These are the things that can actually change people, that can actually get people to go vegan and can make a difference for the animals. So these are the things that we should be concentrating our time, our energy, and our focus onto, not negative comments on YouTube, not in getting in fights with family members, not in just yelling at people. I guess I'm kind of yelling at you right now, but I'm gonna yell anyway. I'm yelling with love. Take that anger and channel into your activism. I mean, even just making a phone call to your congressman and asking them and encouraging them about animal rights legislation will likely take you farther and do more for the animals than making a negative comment on YouTube. There's so much that you can do for animal rights every day. Going and volunteering at the animal shelter, looking at different animal rights organizations and volunteering to help. Go online and sign some petitions. The point is that really, we go farther when we do positive, kind, compassionate things, not negative, hurtful things. So just keep that in mind. And again, it comes back not only to helping the animals, but really, what helps yourself? Do you really feel better if you comment something negative or if you yell at a family member? No, you're gonna feel better if you get in a conversation with someone about veganism and you pass them a leaflet and they walk away and maybe they'll read it. Maybe that's what makes them go vegan. You are creating a more positive impact on this planet and for yourself. Recognizing that anger and seeing what is the most efficient use of this passion, because I think that a lot of times our anger comes down to passion, and passion doesn't have to manifest itself in anger. There's so much we can do with those emotions. I hope that these tips were useful in helping you see some different possible ways that you can perhaps take anger and turn it into compassion. I think that this is something that some of the online vegan community needs. I mean, don't get me wrong, there's so much of the vegan community that is awesome, will always be awesome, super positive, loving, understanding. But at the same time, the reactions, especially to these like ex-vegan YouTubers, it's kind of problematic. Also, just as someone who has so much love and passion for animal rights, I truly do understand where these people are coming from. It's a place of pain. It's a place of wanting to make a difference for innocent, sentient beings who are being slaughtered, tortured, raped every single second of the day. And so, trust me, I understand the place that this is coming from. But at the same time, I recognize that there is a more efficient way to do things that will create more change for these sentient beings. And I think that it's important to tap into that and to really, really approach everything you do with love and compassion. The same love and compassion, because we don't have a limited amount of compassion that we can only give to animals. Our compassion is limitless, and we can give it to human beings who maybe don't see things the way we do right now. And I know it's counterintuitive, but that will take our movement farther. So, did I miss anything? Do you have any tips for how you can turn anger into compassion? I'm always looking for new ones because, honestly, I do get angry quite a lot. It's something I work on, but I'm getting there. So I would love some additional tips if you guys have any. Let me know in the comments down below. And thank you so much for watching. I will see you next week.